disgusting.
A negative 10 out of 10.
Burnt Skittles smell like.
This is actually really good.
This is like tar.
Hey guys, it's Lauren, and today I'm here to bring you guys a brand new video. Today we are going to be testing viral TikTok food life hacks. And so yeah, let's get right on to the video.
Okay, so I'm going to rate 1 through 10. I'm going to tell you guys of what I think of the food. And yeah, let's get on with the video.
So the first one we're going to be doing, I'm not exactly sure what this one is called, but it's like a pizza with, it's like a mac and cheese pizza, I guess. But all you need is a tortilla and mac and cheese and then some shredded cheese. And yeah, let's start making the video.
Okay, so I'm gonna do a time lapse of making the mac and cheese. I guess I'm using a TV dinner, don't judge. And so yeah, let's get on with the time lapse. Well, the next thing you need to do is you need to get a tortilla out. And then I guess what from the video, you put mac and cheese on the tortilla. Now you want to put shredded cheese on top of the mac and cheese, and then you can either warm it up in the microwave or in the oven, it doesn't matter, until the shredded cheese is melted, and then it should be done. Got the shredded cheese all melted, and honestly this looks really fire, so I'm really excited to try this. I'm gonna cut this. Okay, so I didn't bother cutting the whole thing, so I was kind of lazy, and I probably didn't do it long enough. But that's okay, we're gonna try it anyways.
I think you should have done it on the...
I probably should have done it in the oven. Bro.
What does it taste like?
It's really good. This is really good.
Should I try one?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll try one after.
Dude, this is actually really good.
So I forgot to rate the mac and cheese one. So I'm gonna rate that a 10 out of 10 because that was pretty fire.
So the next viral TikTok food life hack we're gonna do, we're gonna make a homemade tortilla chips, and all you need is just oil, and so it doesn't really matter on it basically what it said in the video. So we're gonna be using flour tortillas, and then yeah, let's make the video.
Oh, time to test tasty.
It's not bad. I felt like we could have put it in longer. I'm kind of disappointed on this one. I rate this one probably a 5 out of 10. Do is we're gonna make popcorn and Skittles. And pretty much you just put an oil in the pan, and then you put in Skittles and popcorn. And so yeah, I'm kind of nervous for this one, so let's give this one a try.
Yeah, Lauren, I knew this was a bad idea.
Gone wrong?
Look, you managed to burn the Skittles, Lauren. Now I know what burnt Skittles smell like because of you.
Careful of the oil.
This is like tar. This is like tar, Lauren. It tastes horrendous.
I didn't taste the Skittle or anything.
A disclaimer, do not use microwave popcorn. We didn't have popcorn kernels, so I used microwave popcorn because me thought it was a good idea to use it.
It's actually not that bad. Ah, the aftertaste is no.
What?
Not good. You know how Skittles taste like, right? It, like, you can taste Skittles in it.
and then you can taste the butter popcorn of it and then together. It's just not a good company. Guys, please don't do what I did. Do not use microwave popcorn. Do not use microwave popcorn.
Or you could use microwave popcorn, but put it in the microwave before adding melted Skittles to it.
Use popcorn kernels, which we didn't have popcorn kernels again.
I mean, those technically were, but you know.
Yeah, again, we didn't have popcorn kernels. Okay, so I'm gonna rate that one a 0 out of 10, only because.
No, that is too high of a score. I'd rate it a negative 10 out of 10.
Okay, fine. My sister says I should rate it a negative 10.
I feel violated after seeing that.
A negative 10 out of 10. I did not ruin the pan, luckily. I washed it up and luckily it's not ruined. We're gonna do the next live food hack. A few other people did this in the video, and all you need is Oreos and like a bowl or a plate. So I went to the gas station to get that, because normally our gas station, they have like the big packets of Oreos, but they were out of it. So what you want to do is you want to take this Oreo apart, and then you want to just scrape off the frosting. This is terrible. Okay, we're gonna do a time lapse of this process. So it doesn't matter how many Oreos you add in, but once you put the frosting into the bowl, you put it in the microwave and melt the frosting, and then just be safe, start with 15 seconds. And I guess it depends how much frosting you add in, but just do it till the frosting is at least melted, fully melted. I'll just stir it a little, but this is what it should look like. Want to put the Oreo into the frosting and just make it into like as a dipping sauce, you know? And yeah. Bro.
I gotta try it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I will.
This is good. This is really good. I'm gonna rate this one probably a 9 out of 10 because, I probably should have added more frosting. It probably would have been a lot better if I added more frosting, but my sister wanted Oreos. And so
you gotta pay me for doing this.
All right, that's it for today's video. If you want a part two, please be sure to drop a like and subscribe if you are new, and peace out. Hey guys, it's Lauren, and today we are here to rate.
Hey.
You're going? Hey guys, it's Lauren, and today I'm here to you guys bring you. Oh. Hey guys, if I'm gonna rate it through 1 through 10, if it's good, Sarah, I swear to God, if you laugh one more time, I'm gonna fire you. Sorry, I had to clear my throat. Okay, so we're gonna microwave this mac and cheese, and so I'm probably gonna do a time lapse of the process of making it. So yeah. Sarah!